Hello and welcome back everyone to another tutorial on Tableau. This series of videos will help you take your skills from beginner to expert level in Tableau. Do not forget to hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon so that you are the first one to know whenever I upload any new video. In today's session, we will see how to display dynamic measures with different number formats in Tableau. Let me first show you the demo of what we will be doing today. Here I have a bar chart currently showing sales for different categories like furniture, office supplies and technology. And the labels tell us what was the total sales that were done for a particular category in terms of dollars. Both the charts are same, just a small difference between both these charts, which I am going to tell you in a few seconds. At the top, I have a parameter which gives user freedom whether he wants to see sales for different categories or profit for different categories and profit ratio. Let me select profit. So here you will observe that both the views have updated and the labels tell us what was the total profit for each of the category in terms of dollars. Now let me change the parameter to see profit ratio, which is basically sum of profit divided by sum of sales. Profit ratio should be shown as percentage. You will observe that the first bar chart is showing the profit ratio correctly in terms of percentage, but below you will see that we are not getting the correct percentage, and also the number format is in terms of dollars. So by default, if we turn on labels, then this is how we will get profit ratio in terms of dollars in case when we use parameter to show different measures. Now let's jump to Tableau and see how to show dynamic measures with different number format similar to this one, where we are getting sales and profit correctly in terms of dollars, and also profit ratio is correctly displayed in percentage format. I am using the sample superstore dataset. First of all, let's create a parameter. Click on the drop down and select create parameter. Let's name it matrix parameter. From the data type, we will select string. Click on list, and here we will pass first value will be sales. Second, we want to show profit, and the third value will be profit ratio. Click on OK. Next, we will create a calculated field where we will use this parameter that we have created. Click on the drop down and select create calculated field. We will name it matrix. And here we will write if the matrix parameter is equal to sales, then we want Tableau to show sum of sales, else if the matrix parameter is equal to profit, then we want Tableau to return sum of profit. And lastly, if the matrix parameter is equal to profit ratio, then we want to see sum of profit. Divided by sum of sales. And so when a user will select sales from the matrix parameter, the Tableau will return sum of sales. When a user will select profit from the parameter, then we will get sum of profit. And when the user will select profit ratio from the parameter, then we will get sum of profit. divided by sum of sales. Click on OK. Now drag category column to row shelf. Drag the new calculated field that we created, matrix, into column shelf. Let's change entire view and turn on the labels by clicking on show mark labels button. Now let me also show the parameter by clicking on the drop down and selecting show parameter. So here you will observe that the parameter is selected to sales, and the bar chart shows us sales for different categories: furniture, office supplies, and technology. Let's change the number format of sales to dollars. Right click on the matrix and select format. Go to pane. From here we will select currency custom. We don't want to show any decimal places. Write down 0. And we want the prefix in terms of dollars. Add the prefix dollar sign and display units in terms of thousands. Let's hide this axis by right clicking on axis and uncheck show header. Now here you will observe that we are getting sales for different categories in terms of dollars. Let's change the parameter to profit. So here also we are getting profit in terms of dollars for different categories, which is correct. But now when we will change it to profit ratio, then also the labels will be shown in terms of dollars, which is not correct because the profit ratio should be shown in terms of percentage. By default, a particular display format that we have selected will work for all the measures present inside matrix parameter. The display format is not coming correct for profit ratio, but the display format is correct for sales and profit. So we will create two different calculated fields, one for the profit ratio and another one where we will include both the measures sales and profit. So go to the drop down and click on create calculated field. Let's name it profit ratio label. Here we will write if the matrix parameter is equal to profit ratio, then we want sum of profit divided by sum of sales. So this is the similar calculation that we have written before. Just because we need to show different measures in different formats, that's why we have to create separate field for labels. Click on OK. Now create one more calculated field. Let's duplicate this one. Click on the drop down, select edit. Let's name it profit sales label. Here we will write if matrix parameter is profit, then give us sum of profit, else if matrix parameter is equal to sales, then we want to see sum of sales. Click on OK. Now drag both the fields that we have created for labels to labels under mark section. Let's change the default format of profit and sales label by going to the drop down and selecting default properties number format. We want profit and sales to be displayed in terms of dollars. Let's add dollar in prefix. We don't want to see any decimal places. And let's select display units in terms of thousands. Click on OK. And for profit ratio label, let's select drop down, go to default properties. From the number format, we will select percentage. And we want to see one decimal place. Click on OK. Now you will observe that we are getting profit ratio in terms of percentage. And when we will change the parameter to sales, then the sales are displayed in terms of dollars. And let's select profit. The profit is also shown in terms of dollars for different categories. Now you will observe that in the tooltip, we are getting both the profit ratio label and profit sales label. Let's also correct the tooltip. Go to the tooltip. Here we want the category to be displayed. Then matrix. Here let's add the parameter that we have created. Remove this matrix. Remove these headings. Now add both these labels next to each other. So as you will select sales from the parameter, then here sales heading will be displayed, and then this sales label field will be used, which will show what was the sales for different categories. Similarly, if you select profit, then profit will be displayed here, and the profit number for each category will be displayed using this label field. And as you will select profit ratio from the parameter, then here we will see profit ratio, but now this profit ratio label field will be displayed. Let's click on OK. So here you will see that from the parameter profit is selected. And here we are seeing that profit is $18,000. Now when you will select profit ratio, then the profit ratio is shown in terms of percentage, and even in the tooltip we are getting correct percentage, and also we are getting the heading profit ratio. You can also add this parameter in the title. So let's update this title. Let's write category wise and let's insert the parameter. Click on OK. So profit ratio is selected. Then we are getting the head title as category wise profit ratio. When you will select sales, so the title will update to show category wise sales, and also the view will update. So in this way, we can display the different measures that we have inside the parameter using different number formats. So this was all that I had to cover in this session. I have added the link of this workbook in the description below. Thanks for watching this video. Do not forget to hit the thumbs up button if you like this session. See you in the next session.